Greetings, this is another video overview by the flashlight reviewer Selfbuilt. Today I'm looking at the multitask hybrid series from Nitecore, which follows on the launch of their multitask series a little while ago. I reviewed several members of that light, which are fairly basic, straightforward lights with a straightforward interface. The hybrid version of the multitask series is similar, although it includes a built-in lithium-ion charger and a lithium-ion battery for the respective classes that are offered. Here I have two samples in front of me, the MH1C, which is a 1x CR123A or RCR camera battery style light, and the Nitecore MH25, which is a higher output 1x18650 or 2x CR123A or RCR type light. So the lights, as I mentioned, come with a battery. So in this case, you have an 18650 battery, which I'll open up and show you here. So this is the Nitecore, their own branded battery, 2300 milliamp, protected 18650. You can probably see there, if I can get that maybe angled somewhere up against the white background, you can see there are fairly decent quality screw threads. They're anodized for tail cap lockout. They're not square cut, but they look to be fairly good quality. With the MH1C, you get an RCR or 16340 style battery. In this case, sort of a standard 650 milliamp, again, protected RCR battery. Now, in interface, the lights are fairly similar to the multitask series. Of course, one of the main things that differentiate them when you look at the light, in terms of build, where is the charging port? And it's actually right underneath this kind of area here, which I'll just sort of unscrew. This extra little ring area opens up. And you can see underneath there is a charging port for a USB micro connector, and there's a small LED light there. To sort of show you how all this works, let me open up one of the packages. So inside the box, get everything out here, you get the usual sort of items. You get a warranty card, you get a manual. The Nitecore manuals are fairly decent in that they provide information on a variety of aspects of light, including recommended batteries, runtime, and so forth. You have a fairly standard Nitecore-style belt holster, which has got a Velcro opening, has a open at the end at the bottom to poke through. You have a variety of other additional items with the light here. You have a clip-on-style pocket clip. Seems, you know, fairly good for that style. You have a plastic grip ring, which you can put on near the base of the light, extra O-rings and a tail cap, a boot cover, and a very basic sort of wrist strap. So the standard kind of items that you'd expect to see with the Nitecore light. The other, of course, item here that's a little bit different is the charging cable. So you can see it here. Just open this up. It's a standard USB cable, so you have a USB connector at one end. Goes into your computer. If you have an adapter dongle, you could plug it into AC power. At the other end, you have a micro USB port, kind of the things you'll find on a lot of cell phones and cameras nowadays. So to charge the light, it's fairly straightforward. I'm just going to plug this in here to an adapter I have sitting on my desk. You can see how this works. Let's put that in over there. And we'll just plug it in to the light like so. Now the first thing that happens is you can see it's blinking fairly rapidly. This is the error indication. It's not actually doing anything right now. You actually have to click the light on at the tail cap for the charging to start. So if I click the tail cap, you see it goes solid red. Solid red indicates that the battery inside is actually fully charged. So it's not charging. The charger is supposed to terminate when the battery is fully charged, and that's what the solid red indicates. So it's not actually charging this battery. So what I'm going to do instead, I am going to show you what happens with a partially discharged battery, so you can see the condition. Alright, so we'll just plug that in again. Yeah, it goes this way. So again, it flashes rapidly until you click the tail switch. And there we go. Now it's actually charging this battery. So you have a slow blink, sort of like once every 2 seconds, they say, which gives you the indication that the battery is currently charging. When the battery is fully charged, it'll go to solid red, as you saw a moment ago. And then you can just turn the light off, unplug it, and you're good to go. I noticed there's an O-ring right here, so that should help with some waterproofness when this is closed and in use. I can't really see inside, so I don't know if there's also an O-ring at the base of there. I hope there would be for waterproofness. Always a concern when you have a charging dock type light. Overall build for both lights is kind of what you'd expect. They're a bit taller than the respective members of their class, due mainly to the extra charging dock area and the circuitry involved with that. Although, you know, again, this is not all that atypical compared to the other 18650 lights, just a little bit longer. And you'll see pictures in my review comparing it to other models and samples. Just to show you the body of the light, as you can see, it's pretty straightforward. There's some very basic and not very aggressive knurling here on the ring and here on the tail cap. It doesn't help too much with grip, but there's enough elements, you know, enough distinction along the body that overall grip, I'd say, is fairly decent. I mean, I've seen higher, it's certainly all right. There's a flat brushed stainless steel bezel ring here at the top. You can see at the base there's a cool XML emitter at the base of it, a fairly deep and smooth reflector. Just to show you, here's the MH1C. Again, there's an XML emitter there at the base, and a fairly deep and smooth reflector. This, of course, just has a flat black bezel, although there's a slight crenellation, so you could tell if the light was on when you turn it upside down. Both lights can tail stand. It can be a bit wobbly, but I actually find they're fairly decent on my two samples. Of course, they, you know, headstand. As I say, you can see the light that's on underneath there. Just to sort of show you the interface and beam. So there you've got a fairly traditional beam. Again, the lighting in my office can be a bit misleading. It's actually a fairly cool white, maybe a slight pinkish tone in my case. Hard to see that on the camera. It depends what the light in my office is like. Similar sort of beam here, a bit more of a diffused hotspot because it's got a smaller reflector, so obviously can't be quite as focused. Again, hard to see on the camera, but you'll have to just sort of take my word for it. The interface is the same on both lights. With the head tight, you get maxed output. With the head loosened, you get the define, I think they call them daily modes, where you can cycle at the tail cap between the various output modes. So you can see there was a high, medium, and kind of low. There's a SOS mode and a strobe mode back to high. This high is lower than the head tight condition, which is kind of a turbo mode. So that's actually a bit brighter. I loosened again. You can probably see there's a bit of a drop down in output. A comment about the mode sequence here. The light does have mode memory, so if you take it down to the lowest mode, you turn the light off, you wait a few seconds, when you turn the light back on, it will remember where you were and always come back on at that low output level. But it takes a bit of time to memorize. So if I go back, say, to this level, turn it off, wait just a couple of seconds, turn it back on, you see it advanced to the next mode. So you have to give it like a good 5 seconds there to really have it memorized. That's kind of longer than I typically like to see. I like to have a more quick memorization feature. But all in all, not bad. I also prefer not to see the blinking modes in the main sequence. But again, that's kind of unfortunately fairly common on sort of entry-level, more basic style lights. Anyway, that's kind of an overview of the two lights. To see more about the lights, including details on their runtime, performance, and comparison to other lights, please see my full review at Candle Power Forums. You'll find me in the review form under the username selfbuilt, or at my newly revamped website, flashlightreviews.ca. Hope you found that useful. Thanks for your time.